You know, John, I don't understand that thing you're talking about. What they call clear of money. I know this. My wife-dealer says the same thing as your wife-dealer. And that's all that matters to you. But you can talk and talk and talk, and it goes in this year, out here, because I'm like Jim here, I never went to school. You see? So, but I know what's in here of you. And that's the thing I'm begging. Not you, your wife. And so, you know, I always go back to when we got off the Dominion Monarch after the war. The colonel said to us, he lined us all up, 1,000 of us. And he said to us, "You have made me proud. You have made the married people proud." He said, "One last command I give to you. Now remember, we took the oath on in 1941, the Pocahontas Oath. And we lived the Pocahontas life while we were fighting the battle in Egypt and Greece and Crete and Italy. We lived that life. And it was a successful life because we all lived it together, A company, B company, C company, D company, and headquarters company. And when we were dismissed, he said, "One last command I give to you." Now remember, we weren't dismissed then. "One last command I give to you." We were still in the army. "Go back to your mountains, go back to your marae. Go back to your people and be the Rangatira that you are." And then the dismiss came. But don't forget that command was still in the army. So I'm still in the army with that, those words. You see? There's two paths to me. And then he gave the order to 8th Battalion, dismiss. That's another thing. We weren't in the army. Commander was given us in. And you know, I've seen a whole lot of us from 2-8 Battalion. There's only 3 of us left. There's only 2, one from down East Coast. His name is Rutan Owen, and he's from C Company. And B Company is, D Company is followed by the name of Priest from Chad Mullins. And so, sometimes I get a bit confused over the whole thing, especially when someone gives a me to a 2-8 Battalion, and I'm talking about the Iwi Chairs. I say, "Now, who's the 2-8 Battalion? There's nothing here." And then I realize the 2-8 Battalion is me, and I never gave him a pakote. I didn't fuck out to his talk, or I should have. So I went to the head of Tainui, the king's spokesman. I said to him, "You know, I don't know whether I should go out and fuck out to me. I told me I pulled off the thing to come out on me." He said, "Well, you should." He said, "That comes before all things else." So I'm clear from my long waiver. And I'm not clear. And so, John, don't worry what Bundy and I think. If you go down, you go down. Goodbye. But we're still going to back you till you do go down. Yeah. And we're not going to be smiling sideways at ourselves when you talk. You talk, I don't understand what you're talking about. But it's all good as far as I'm concerned, whether I can understand it or not. So, Jim, you got the actual workings of the whole thing of your part. You've made it work. Thank you. We've got someone like Jim. And Jim, we want to put him up on the board I know I've made mine. And mine is a real, I don't know what you call it. Everyone was against me. People were against me. Only one fellow fighting the government. One fellow fighting the police. One fellow fighting everyone. I don't care. I don't care. All I know is my wife says I should be there and I'm going to be there. And if any of you fellows can live as hard as I can, I'll shake your hand. Bundy knows how hard I live. You know? Now I got no lights, no nothing. But I got all the machinery, got bulldozers and diggers and big Mack trucks and all that and nothing. And you fellas can do the same. Don't come talking to me about how you haven't got this and how you haven't got it. Start bleeding away. You can all do your own thing around yourselves. Because if it's around yourselves, it's around us. And what's around me is around you. And Buddy knows this too. Buddy and I are going to go up and chop cheaply. But I've got about 5 miles of road to do. And you know, with a pension, can't do much. But I do a lot. You've got to work out how to do it. And I'm listening to this co-master here talking, and he's talking about the leadership of Gartney and all this and that. Well, to me, we don't have to be talking about our leadership. We just do it. And if it bypasses us, what the party recognizes or what he doesn't recognize, too bad. But I'd like to see us go back up to Reading or Waiula and spend a day or two up there. Mm-hmm. And all those, and our minister, where is he? Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Don't forget you too, because your blessings don't go amiss. They don't go amiss. You might think you're talking to no one, but you're talking to us and it's right in here. Yeah. And we understand what you are. So don't you go jumping on the cook's boat. He won't help. So, good to see you here, Nelson. And everyone else. I think we'll go home tonight. We've got to go home. Anyway, Jim, I've been trying to get your name. I don't know, Bundy has told me a couple of times and I forgot.
All you have to think about is 2 weeks, Coro. Hey? Week or two.
Hey?
2 weeks. Week or two.
Week or two.
That's my name.
Good one. So, all of you fellas, I thank you. You're on the right track. Get to know someone, get to know yourselves, who you are. That's all you're going to do. Don't you get to know me, because if you get to know me, you'll get in trouble. Yeah, if you get to know Bundy, you'll get in trouble. Get to know yourselves. Think about your tupuna, what they have to go through, and so forth, and so forth, and so forth. And combine our strengths together, and we'll get it. So, one day, maybe in the future, I'm going to take Willis. Bundy and I will take Willis up to the Gumpians and show you the Gumpians. We've got, we sit there and we say, anyone wants to fight us? They can fight us. Yeah. Marilyn, going to want to fight? Yeah, we'll give you a fight. Yeah, what college did you go to? Nothing. The only college I come from is Rock College. I was in there in Egypt. So, all things aside, you just got to make up your mind to fight everyone, whether they be Crown or whatever they call themselves, fight the buggers. And I've had far guys coming up to me and saying, gee, that's great. When I made out, I was worse than I was. I was a beggar, begging in the street. And well, how it started, I went to get my pension, and there was a woman said, well, there's no pension here for you. I said, well, where's my pension? Oh, the courts have stopped the pension because you want to recognize their courts. I said, is that so? She said, yeah. I said to my girl, I'm going to get a chip and something to write on. So she went up, not long back, had this cardboard to write on. No food, no booze, no nothing, no sex, no nothing. And I sat on the street. Next thing, this party woman came along, three of us. And I just held out my hand on this, money for the poor. And next thing, they were doing the zips on their purses, 18 bucks. And so next thing, this manager of Wynn's come out and said, you can't do that. I said, what the hell are you talking about, lady? Can't you see I'm doing it? And she said, well, I'll soon put a stop to that. And I said, yeah, go on. No, she rang the police. Next thing, the police car came out. And lo and behold, one of the policemen was my mortgage. And he came around. And he said, you know, granddad, you're a disgrace to the family. I said, what the hell do you know about disgrace to the family? I said, hey, who told you to come down here and arrest me? Oh, the sergeant. And did you bring your handcuffs? Yeah, I got them right here. I said, well, you, your handcuffs, and your sergeant, get lost. I said, I'm on business here. He looked at me and he said, what'll the family think about it? Said, don't you worry about the family. I said, they're doing a deal of heart of blood and you deal with me, so get lost. Anyway, next morning when I woke up, my daughter came to me and said, you know, Dad, you've got the highest poll of anyone. I said, what? He said, all around these old mills, 136,000 people that don't know what you. And Mary TV came up. He said, you got 136,000? I said, so. Anyway, next thing came from Australia. And they said, it's 200,000 from Australia, RSL. And next thing, there was America. A few from America started to play out. And next thing, the police come along to me and they says, look, take your money here. And I said, I'm getting a lot of money from Canada. It's coming through. Don't worry about Canada. You'll go to jail. Take the money now. And they gave me all this money. But, you know, you've got to be a bit stupid like me to be able to do these things. Just do it. And they say, they blame me for all sorts of things. First time they blame me for burning down the school. Well, I said, I didn't burn the school down. There was a spring of light in there, dude. So anyway, that went by. But a lot of things happened. You know, I was talking about Maury money, though. I know Maury. I've been on this road a long time. And all of you, you're all qualified, the whole bang lot of you. You know, do your thing. Stand up for your children. Stand up for your grandchildren. Stand up for the whole lot. And be part of the women government for what they've done to us. It's only temporary as far as they're concerned. And as far as you're concerned, John, I don't know where the hell it's going. But it's all good.
Humble because I'm actually hearing your people talking. Thank to some people down the road. We have a drive. Got involved in a bit of a session down there. And the outcome from that session, you took a whole lot of shit out of my head. And things like fear, stress, anxiety, depressed. Got rid of it. And it gave my head a whole lot of space. It took me about a week plus to understand the space in my head. You know, so it's allowed me to hear more clearly. Took a whole lot of mail off my shoulders. It's also allowed me to identify the shit coming. And allow it to happen while it's happening. But I'm getting overloaded inside here like a volcano ready to burst and get it down like a madman. That's why I'm saying I'm kind of humble because I'm actually hearing a talk. And clarifying to me that I know people among our people are doing stuff what they believe in relation to what where our worlds need to go. And for me, sitting in Watangi, I know one day we're all going to get together. And when we do come together, that time is going to tell us we're going to go and do it. While I had all this bloody crap in my head, struggling. Put his leg forward, and then the next one, and the next one. I'm struggling with all of that, what's going on, and what's happening. I hear the people talking, and I hear people talking, but I don't see the talk. Some sitting there frustrated. What the hell? You know. So I have to look at ourselves at, in my thing. Who's the who, who's the what? And actually start to hear the cry of our people. And I see the two-face, the neon again. That was bloody anti. The all sorts. So we'll be getting together in Waitangi to strengthen ourselves and tidy up some of the struggle we've been going with to face up with these people. They're all bloody shit. And having the cut to get a cone to stand and do that stuff. One party was only two of us. Our people were getting had enough. You don't want to get involved with what's going on with the rarira and our whānau, you know, three splits. They ended up with two of us meeting. But somehow inside us, because we're here to talk about people. We hear the direction of what they're saying. And that's what kept us together. today. The two of us are sitting at the helm. One's the chairman of the Marae Trustees. The other one, myself, the Kai Whakaari of the Māori Committee. And the umbrella of the Whakapitonga. I'll look at my mate Ngāti Kaua, who is the porter of the Marae Trustees. I'll look at him at the Runanga in the talking. A tool. So, standing side by side without over coming over one another, side by side, we have to work together and utilize each other to knock out the tickle in Waitangi. And I believe we've done that. We've done it. Yeah, they're quiet, baby, they're going to get over the bridge. They're going over the bridge to get that count. Do what they used to do to all of us. So I encourage our people to continue their money. Do what you believe in. Because we do the same thing in Waitangi. So when we do come together, and we can get together to the next year. That's the money I'm doing in Waitangi. The kōrero, I heard of the kōrero. I'm just so proud to be part of our world. I come back in 10 years ago in May. And I don't believe when I left home in 1970 at 15 years old. Go out to the big world and have a look when you really come back. I got out there, partly by the maps, and I have a look there, got involved, and only one more I knew, play up, crack, do the right thing, you win. So I had a tutu in life, a little bit of education, learn how Pākehā do business, learn how big boy do business. So when I sit around with those fellows, I know their kōrero and I know their language. So I enjoyed my life hanging with look what's out there. When I come home, the one thing, my biggest challenge would be our people. And of course, I don't have the reo and the ears for the language. But I have these fellas, I have my feelings. I can feel good, bad, and ugly. And I can see good, bad, and ugly. The confirmation to understand what bad and ugly is, I look at my neighbor. Their body language telling me, supporting what I'm feeling, what I'm seeing. If it's good, supporting what I'm seeing, what I'm feeling. So we're in. That's how I see it. I know our people got the kōrero, I know our people got the history, and I know our people got the tools. And I know our people need an opportunity to read you at night, and we're going to do that. So, and of course today, we were told, Waitangi did the right job today by hiring the marae out and who they decide for Ngāpuhi. fight it today. They also want to fight it today. The Portland, what time the day up the hill? And the other people, the Marai said, Hari, we're staying and we're going to do what we always do. We're going to continue. That's where we are. I want to thank some people tonight for Afina Teutoko, the Manaki, the Koha, the Watangi Marae, when we get together for the Hui, the Whakaputanga, Ngahuru, Watangi Day. You know, without your support, being Watangi, we'll be picking pippies every day. That's the aroha for me to the people that support us in Waitangi. And without the final hapu support, that's where the power lies. Well, I cry baby, they are there, we lead in that. That's all I do. They give nothing. They give nothing. Except Shane Jones. I must honor, respect Shane Jones. Regardless, he goes, does he tough? He always koha. I'm glad I came tonight to listen to the quarter. And I think you're in the right direction with your agenda and where you could go. Good to see you again, John. I found it quite hard when I come in Waitangi and I see a whole lot of look like nonsense, people screaming, jumping and cramping and that wild ass chucking me out. I'm just glad I did the road trip and it took a whole lot of me out of my head so I can do it without getting dressed and frustrated. But I just want to thank it to everybody. I'm gonna hit the road. I need to see my wife 5 minutes every day. I love my wife very much. And sometimes I need to have a bit of time with her. And, once again, thank us all.
Yes. I was thinking about the song today, you see, so I thought I have to sing the song. I have to sing the song. Okay? It's not a Maori one. So I've got a few paragraphs, and it goes, who's that tripping over my bridge? It's a baby goat. It's a baby goat. Okay? You can cross. Who's that tripping over my bridge? See, I'm referring to the hooey we had today. The mother went. And then, who's that tripping over our bridge? This troll under the bridge. But the question is, they're so sure that there's going to be a bridge there on the 6th of February, aren't they? They're assuming there's going to be a bridge there. No, I'm not saying that there's not going to be a bridge there. I'm just saying that,
But it's always good to see yourself and everything. And I thank you, buddy. I appreciate you, buddy, and it allows you to get in one thing. Cut to the chase. Good. Done. You know, and I like it. Get us out in good years. And power by be with us. Oh, beauty, man. Good one. Okay, everybody,
Just before they go, there's a little bit of kai here for everybody.
You know, we've got
our... I'm a little uncomfortable with that. Yeah. Any food?
Not this one.